It's a big day at Prehistoric Park. Throughout this huge reserve, everyone is busy preparing for the first arrivals.
Come on, lads, quick as you like.
Can you get a 10-foot pole down the bottom of the paddock?
They're almost finished building the enclosures for everything from giant insects to dinosaurs.
Remember, check everything. This is home to a dangerous creature.
If Nigel can make extinct animals feel at home anywhere, it's here.
The natural geography will help us contain the animals. There's the ocean to the south, and to the north, there's a mountain range. Everything I need in terms of habitats. There's savanna, there's forest, there's rivers, there's even a waterfall. Perfect environments for keeping prehistoric animals.
All they need now are the prehistoric creatures themselves. One day, Nigel plans to breed extinct animals in captivity. But his first step is to only bring a few of each species back to see how they get on in the 21st century. And Nigel knows exactly what he wants to start with. The meanest and scariest of them all. Tyrannosaurus Rex.
The most widely accepted theory about why dinosaurs became extinct is a meteorite smashed into the Earth. This is a map of the Earth 65 million years ago. This is where the impact was, somewhere here in Mexico. You can still see the crater today. Around that time, there were masses of T-Rex here, somewhere in Montana, and I need to go back there to find them.
To rescue the last of the T-Rex, Nigel is going back to the very end of the age of dinosaurs. As close to the meteorite impact as he dares. Million years ago, Montana looks very different. This is a world before grass, where volcanoes dominate the landscape. Here, T-Rex is king. Now, all Nigel needs to do is to find one. T-Rex is a monster. At a staggering 45 feet long and 5 tons, it shouldn't be too hard to track one down. What he'll do when he does find one is not exactly clear.
Thank you.
And up above are the first signs that the meteorite is closing in. Streaking across tonight's sky are shooting stars. Huge boulders are plowing into the Earth's atmosphere at 20,000 miles an hour. They are the precursor of something much, much bigger.
Look at this cosmological activity going on here. Those are meteors. Nothing to worry about. They burn up in the atmosphere. But they're in the bow wave of the meteorite. And a meteorite, when that comes through, that's going to smack into the Earth. And that's the problem. And, you know, we really have got such little time here. But I'm hoping tomorrow it's going to go better and we can save a T-Rex or two.
The following morning, the camp has some visitors. More creatures in the last throes of their existence.
A glorious sight to wake up to, a big herd of triceratops. This is a tremendous sight. When the fossils were found, they named these things Triceratops horridus. It means horrid three-horned face. But how could they? They are gorgeous. And big too, 8 tons. And one over there, that's a big male. It's at least 25 feet, 8 meters long. And the good thing for us is there is a lot of them. They're prey animals for T-Rex. I've seen some tracks of the predator over there. Prey and predator attracted to water holes. And what I'm going to try to do is follow the tracks and see if we can find a T-Rex lair.
The footprints are fresh, and it looks like a well-used track. T-Rex are fast movers, reaching 40 miles an hour when they need to. Nigel's hoping these ones aren't too far away.
Really beginning to tell a story, look here. Depression in the ash, that was a big tail sweep. And there's impressions here from bodies. There was a kerfuffle here, I think. Another tail drag over there. And the tracks are going on. I think we're getting towards the centre of the territory.
What Nigel doesn't realise is he's actually already in the centre of their territory.
and transport it. Route to collect the asset being transported in. set transit.
And right into the upper thigh. We'll be right back.
He's magnificent.
Oh.
Awaiting asset delivery.
Su calzado de velar, háganlo ya. O bueno, si están.
Meanwhile, Nigel has at last come up with a plan of his own.
What we're trying is a technique used by game capture teams for things like antelope. We know the T-Rex is working her way downriver. We've got ahead of her. She won't go over onto this uneven ground. We know she doesn't like going near the water. We've built this palisade of logs, and we're going to funnel her straight towards the time portal and back to the safety of the 21st century. We hope.
The meteorite's getting ever closer. So is the T-Rex. And a herd of ornithomimus are running scared.
And there she is, the T-Rex. That's why they're spooked. If we're lucky, she'll chase them right through the time portal, and we could have a breeding colony of ornithomimus at Prehistoric Park.
Trapped between the T-Rex and the 21st century, they opt for the portal.
Yep, one, two. They are belting through, a whole phalanx of them. Bob is going to get a real surprise.
Oh, my giddy aunt. Nigel, what are you doing?
Suzanne, we've got a bit of a situation here.
One Ornithomimus is slower than the rest.
She took the Ornithomimus right there. It's just a snack for her. It was a juvenile. We just cannot afford to lose her. I do not want to go back to Prehistoric Park empty-handed.
Hundreds of miles away, the meteorite has finally entered the Earth's atmosphere at 20,000 miles an hour. The sonic boom it creates is one of the loudest noises the world has ever known. As it strikes the Gulf of Mexico, it causes an explosion 7 billion times more powerful than the Hiroshima bomb. It releases a blast front moving at 100 times the speed of sound. This devastation is just the start. The cloud of ash will soar into the sky and molten rock will start raining down, igniting global wildfires. And as it mushrooms out, it will engulf the entire world in a blanket of darkness. All this is just 3 minutes away. Nigel will have to think fast. Nigel has finally managed to rescue T-Rex from extinction. Meanwhile, Bob settling in the herd of highly strung Ornithomimus.
Oh, all right. They're still a bit stressed out from the capture. They're just walking round and round the perimeter fence. I suppose they're checking out their new home. But they'll be all right. I'm not going to feed them till tomorrow, though. Just let them settle in a bit.
Thank you.
But for now, all eyes are on the T-Rex pen. Let's hope Prehistoric Park knows what it's letting itself in for.